بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. First of all, we welcome Sheikhna Ahmed. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to benefit us bihi وينفعه بنا. To ينفعنا به وينفعه بنا. And I feel shy to sit بين يديه. أعظكم وأفقهكم إن سمح لي. يقول الإمام الطحاوي أبو جعفر رحمه الله عز وجل، وقوله خلق الخلق بعلمه وقدر لهم أقدارا وضرب لهم آجالا ولم يخف عليه شيء قبل أن يخلقهم وعلم ما هم عاملون قبل أن يخلقهم. Imam Tahawi rahimahullah, in his Aqeedah al-Tahawiyya, we reach a point where he says, and Allah Azza wa Jal, where he's still talking about Allah and his names and attributes and what he can or what he does and what he did. He said he created the creation according to his eternal knowledge. خلق الخلق بعلمه، والخلق يستلزم العلم. الخلق يستلزم العلم. يقول الله عز وجل ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير. أنت without knowledge cannot create what you're gonna create. Without knowing what you're creating cannot create. So when we say someone creates, immediately we have to understand from that that he has knowledge of what he's created. وهذا معناه الخلق يستلزم العلم. والله عز وجل says ألا يعلم من خلق. Doesn't he know who he created؟ وهو اللطيف الخبير. الله عز وجل he knows how to create, so he created, and he knows everything about who he created. He knows everything about whom he created. فإحنا لو ضربنا المثل ولله المثل الأعلى، you find that companies that produce any product they keep secrets of their product. حتى في أبسط الأشياء، يعني تكون أكلة مثلا أو بهارة، يقول لك هذه لها سر، هذه الخلطة لها سر. هو يعني wants to be specialized in it. He doesn't want to give his secret to anyone. وهذا at our level and at simple things. So when we say Allah Azza wa Jal created us and we believe in that, then we have also to believe, part of believing that He created us, we must believe that He knows everything about us. He knows everything about us. فهذا again the meaning of الخلق necessitates knowledge. يعني when we say creation, immediately you should understand it's accompanied with knowledge, complete knowledge that encompasses what we feel in everything regarding this creation. Okay, this creature, we have to understand that the creator of such creature has knowledge of every single aspect of this creature that he created. Other than that, it will not be the perfection that Allah Azza wa Jal deserves. This is one of مراتب القدر، الإيمان بالقدر. الإيمان بالقدر one of its levels to believe that Allah عز وجل created everything with his knowledge. Okay? And obviously the أدلة in the Quran and the Sunnah are many regarding this fact that Allah Azza wa Jal knows. And Allah Azza wa Jal يعلم. فيقول الله عز وجل وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ. And know that Allah knows everything about you. مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ هذه الفكرة أو الخاطرة. يعني something that still did not come into existence. بل أنت maybe you are not sure of your own thought. Allah, أنا I don't think or I'm not sure. Should I do this or should I do that? مش متأكد. الله يعلم. الله يعلم. الله يعلم ما كان. وما هو كان وما يكون وما هو كان وما لا كان وما لم يكن لو كان كيف يكون. هذا الله عز وجل. فأنت when you understand that about Allah عز وجل and perhaps what I will say you will not find in the books of العقيدة because the books of العقيدة gives you the borders. The books of العقيدة give you the borders of العلم. Gives you what you can believe and what you cannot believe. But it doesn't take you to the level where this aqeedah becomes connected directly to your spirituality. Okay? Huwa is telling you what Allah is and what Allah is not. That is what the books of aqeedah are focused on. Hudud. It tells you, tu'min bi kada, la tu'min bi kada. Amma to take you to the next level, that's where you need to make the effort. And that's when they start talking about the spirituality and what, how can I put this? طيب, now I know Allah created everything. Now I know Allah knows everything. طيب, how is this going to help me to connect with Allah? ماشي? That's the point. That's the main aspect. So once you look in these ayat, once يعني القرآن المكي, most of it talks about العقيدة. Quran al-Makki. Whatever was revealed before the Hijrah in Mecca, most of it speak about this. About who Allah is. Okay? To establish arguments with the kuffar and to elevate the believers to know who their God is. Now I understand that even if I have thought, a fikra, I'm not sure about or not sure of, and I know Allah knows it. When I know that Allah Azza wa Jal يعلم عملي وفعلي وقولي وحالي وخاطرتي وفكرتي, all this, what it's going to do to you? How it's going to make you live? Once this start penetrating and becomes part of your system, these beliefs become part of your system, then a lot of change is going to happen to your life. The one who disobeys Allah. Huwa fi tilka al-lahza, in that moment, did he think that Allah is watching him? In tashuf, if you imagine someone looking at you through the keyhole. And you're about to commit zina, will you? Most probably no one will. Illa the nufajir. Bas hatta al-fajir. Mumkin, maybe he will be shy to commit zina, knowing that someone is watching. Why? Khalas, that's how it is. So once you start developing your knowledge of Allah Azza wa Jal to the point where you reach that greatest station in Islam, انت عندك دائرة الإيمان, دائرة الإسلام, and then a smaller circle, دائرة الإيمان. For every Muslim, every mu'min, Muslim. But not every Muslim, mu'min. Every Muslim is Muslim. Every Muslim, every mu'min reached the stage of Islam and now he's at higher step. ثم تجيك دائرة أصغر. دائرة الإحسان. وهذا حديث جبريل المشهور. فإيفري مسلم, إيفري محسن, مؤمن ومسلم. هذا الإحسان فيها درجتين. إجمالا يعني. Two stages. أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. To worship Allah as if you see him. But if you can't see him, he sees you. So the highest level is to worship Allah as if you see him. The next lower than that is still in the circle of al-ihsan is to know that he sees you. And a big difference between someone in the stage of al-ihsan and someone who's still struggling with his Islam. All that, how did he reach there? How a person reaches a point where he starts believing and living. Now we all believe. We all believe. كلنا نؤمن أن الله يرانا. بس كم منا يعيش أن الله يرانا؟ We all believe. ما هو الكافر believes. كافر believes that Allah sees him. But until when we gonna continue to be like the kuffar? أنت مؤمن. ماشي. That's where the aqidah comes in. Handy. The more you hear about Allah, even in your unconscious mind, خلاص. شوف that the psychologist, علماء النفس. They tell you there is the conscious mind and the unconscious mind. The unconscious mind, أحمق. غبي. هذا العقل الباطني بيسمى. غبي. You have to keep repeating to it. العقل الظاهر. Or the conscious mind has to keep feeding the unconscious mind. Giving it. Repeating. But suddenly with too much repetition, the unconscious mind becomes in charge of the conscious mind. وأحمق in the way he learns. But very powerful in the way he leads. That's why the unconscious mind, you will put in it stuff that you will never forget. 20, 30 years, you don't use it. 20, 30 years, it comes out. Because it was stored in there. But based on what you put in there, your conscious mind start behaving. يعني حتى to the point where they tell you, those يعني psychologists who connect psychology with Islam. يربطوا علم النفس بالإسلام. فيقول لك no wonder that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم order us, for example, to say Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, بعد كل صلاة, because that eventually will lead, repetition. You find skills how those, يعني psychologists treat patients based on these facts that they had concluded. Now, some people don't even believe in that unconscious mind, but هم from experience and لا مشاحة في الألفاظ. Doesn't matter what you want to call it. But the bottom line is, it's experience and it works. So someone comes to them, for example, the way they treat them. What's your problem? أنت شو مشكلتك؟ ليش رايح على الطبيب النفسي؟ يقول له أنا بخاف من كل شيء. بشو بخايف من خيالي. I see my ظل, my shadow on the wall, I get scared. So one of the way they treat them, of course, يعني, if this is his problem and it can be treated with this, he tells him, this is what we're going to do. How he treats him. He said, every day, morning and evening, you will say with yourself for 10 minutes. And you just say, I'm not scared. I'm not scared. Just keep repeating to yourself. I'm not scared. I'm not scared. I'm not scared. Now this sounds, might sound stupid to a lot of people. But if he becomes, if he's willing and he's open to change, it will start going deeper in his unconscious mind. As a reaction, this unconscious mind starts believing that this person is not afraid. So it starts leading his external behavior. He's not scared. And it works a lot of the times. So إحنا when we talk repeatedly over and over and over, وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين. طيب شو what's the point? If he knows already, why I need to remind him? ففي الإعادة إفادة. Benefit comes with repetition. You keep repeating things. شوف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول مروا أولادكم بالصلاة لسبع واضربوهم عليها لعشر. Order your children to pray at 7 years old. And hit them on it if they don't pray at 10. شوف انت between 7 and 10, 3 years. In 3 years you're not allowed to hit. طب in 3 years. Go back to the calculation. 3 years. With 350 days, عندك 1000 يوم. 1150. 1000 days. Let's make it simple. 1000 days. Every day 5 prayers. 5000 صلاة. ماشي. فأنت before you become qualified to hit, your child, you have to tell him to pray 5000 times. طب ما هو غصب عن اللي خلفه. After 5000 times هيصلي. بعد 5000 مرة صلي حيصلي. ماشي. But who's willing? Which parent willing to do that? Parent who's concerned. أب أو أم مهتمين بأبنائهم. He gonna do that 5000 times. و20000. ماشي. خلاص. It becomes part of this child system. بس إحنا إيه؟ We're lazy, and we don't want to try. And what we do, we get angry. We get angry with that child. So we make him hate it. So if he prays, he might pray because he's scared of you. Or he doesn't want to hear you. But once he's on his own, or once you're not there, no sorry. Imagine. Very important. So when we talk about العقيدة over and over and over, because we have, and why I bring this up, because you have people today who tells you, we're all Muslims. We all say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasul. Why we need to talk about العقيدة? شو الهدف من الكلام عن العقيدة? وهذا, whoever says that, if you ask him the basics in his عقيدة, he will fail to answer. He will fail to answer. And if one of أهل البدع and one of the people who deviated with their عقيدة tells him something, he will believe. Because he doesn't know. Very important. عقيدة هو أصلاً السماوات والأرض created for this عقيدة. Everything created for this عقيدة. To know Allah and to worship. Yes. So if the greatest and the most honorable هو العلم. هو كيف تعرف انت شرف العلم? How you know if certain knowledge is honorable or not? Or the status of knowledge in its honor? How you know which is more honor than others? Based on what? Based on what subject it discusses. شرف العلم بالمعلوم. The honor of knowledge based on what this knowledge, specific knowledge, discusses. So when it comes to al-aqidah, discusses what? Allah. And who's more honorable than Allah? And everything else. All the other knowledge. علم التفسير وعلم الحديث وعلم السيار وعلم كذا وعلم منها كل العلوم شرعية وغير شرعية. It's all for one reason to get you to know Allah. كلها خادمة كل العلوم خادمة لعلم العقل. هو ليش تفسير طبعا انت you can find تفاسير الجملة. You can find تفاسير unlimited number of تفاسير for the Quran. والبعض وكثير من المفسرين طلاب، بل بعضهم زنادق، زنادق زنديق يعني كافر، مفسر عنده تفسير قرآن. تفاسير كل العلوم هذه there to serve علم العقيدة، to get you to Allah. Today you find people, a lot of people miss this point. So he goes to learn some knowledge or some field. He studies every single text in that field. What's the benefit? Every single text. هو أصلا maybe the third text on the list, the first and the second text included in it. يجي مثلا الأجرمية which is في النحو. Then he goes ألفية بالمال. Then شذور الذهب. Then all these books. What you need في النحو. You need the basic علم to understand what you read. بس هو يقول so much. For what? And he starts talking about issues that brings no benefit to no one, brings no benefit to anyone. العلم must be that you learn what you will use to serve العقيدة. To serve people and to serve yourself before that, how to get to Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's what we need to learn. That's what we need to learn. Now when we teach Tariq al-Andalus, just so we can, if we go to on Jeopardy, we can answer the questions about Andalus. Most probably they'll never have category about Andalus. We don't do that. So we can know who killed whom. Because we gonna look at it to connect us with those who were really connected with Allah. To show us that when you are connected with Allah, how far you can go. That's why I chose these topics. As much as hard to choose a topic, as much as it's easy to know where you need to go, as long as you know your purpose. As long as you know your purpose. And our main purpose is, if not the only purpose, to serve the deen of, or the aqeedah of Allah, the aqeedah of Islam. To know Allah. Once you know Him, خلاص. في فرق. There's difference between knowing Allah and living what you know about Allah. Let's differentiate. Allah al-Khaliq. I know Allah al-Khaliq. أنا أعلم أن الله الخالق. Beautiful. How many people, Muslims and non-Muslims, know that? But for me to live my life knowing that Allah al-Khaliq, or maybe if I use simpler example, to connect with Allah al-Muhit. يعني Allah encompasses everything. He knows everything. Everyone knows that. طيب how am I as a Muslim different? And كيف, how can I be different? I have to live that piece of information. Just to know Allah, المحيط, this is piece of information. General information. And that's not the point. Is how I gonna live my life and put into practice this piece of information. That's what makes a mu'min different than kafir. So you come to your interactions, you come to halal and haram, you come to your relationships, you come, what you look around, you come. Allah al-Muhit, Allah yarani. As much as they advanced, in surveillance, in spying, cameras, satellites, as much as they advanced. If you're driving, or you're walking, and you're driving and you see some girl, a woman walking in the street, you're driving, you look. Medium security. Who will ever know that? No one will catch this. Only, maybe if you're right next to you, she will catch it, But most of the time she doesn't. She's watching. فرج علينا ها شكلنا احنا عايشين مع بعض ها مين انت لحالك يور الون مو كان كاتش انت فراكشن اوف ا سكند باك الله يعلم خائنة الأعين Allah knows. فهذا when you learn that piece of information that Allah محيط and then you live it. That's what makes you different. That's what will make you different. فخلق الخلق بعلمه. Knows everything about his creation. But Allah Azza wa Jal knows what's gonna be of you before he created. Again. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلَ الْأَعْلَى. And what they do, these companies that make electronics, especially phones, let's use phones, iPhones. What happens every few months? And sometimes even within a couple of months you get it twice or three times. Upgrades. تحديث. ليش؟ Why this تحديث؟ Why these upgrades؟ If you open the information for upgrades, what they tell you in there? Or even apps. Forget about the big phone. One app, every now and then they get upgrades. Why? What they call them? When? What they call bugs? They're correcting or fixing some bugs. Is that what they call bugs? They're correct. They're problems with the app itself or with that device that they cannot know. They cannot know those mistakes unless it gets used by many, many people. So then they figure out, okay, you got 10 million people using and 9 million complaining of the same problem. That means it's a problem. يعني صارت متواترة هذه المشكلة. So they go upgrade. So no one knows what's gonna be of everything, even if they make it in their own hands. بس الله. That's the difference between the علم of Allah and the علم of others. That's the difference between the علم of the creator, Allah, and the علم of someone who creates something of this. So then, if we understand that, then we have no issues to accept that Allah knows. So we don't need to go so far to say, Allah doesn't know. If you say Allah knows, that means you're comparing Him to His creation. The ilm of Allah is one thing and our ilm is one thing. There is no comparison. There is no comparison between the ilm of Allah and my ilm. But for me, the only solution for me is to say Allah doesn't know so I can save myself the headache. Doesn't work this way. يقول الله عز وجل: وعنده مفاتح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو، ويعلم ما في البر والبحر، وما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها، ولا حبة في ظلمات الأرض، ولا رطب ولا يابس إلا في كتاب. عنده علم كل شيء. We believe in all that. So these are adillah in the Quran that Allah عز وجل knows. And we said, the creation necessitates علم, knowledge. لازم. You cannot create without علم. أما علم, بس علم الله عز وجل, هو he knows exactly what will be of his creation before he created them. Which is a simple example I gave you about these apps. There is no need for Allah to do upgrades for his creation, because he knows exactly how they will function and how they intended to function before he created. He knows what they will do before he created. فهذا هو الخلق كامل. This is the perfect creation. Okay? Perfect creation. علمه تعالى محيط بالأشياء. His knowledge encompasses everything. Encompasses the action of people. Encompasses or the actions of the creation. Encompasses the speech of the creation. Encompasses the thoughts of the creation. Encompasses what the creation did not do had they done it. طيب, then now you still have a problem that when I say Allah knows, that I'm comparing him to his creation. Like, why we need to talk to about this? We all know this. Because you have groups that deviated because of shubuhat. من تسبب الضلال اثنين. Okay? The causes of all misguidance, two things. In totality. الشهوات والشبهات. الشهوات سهل. الشهوات سهل. هي الشبهات بالدم. الشبهات. That really destroy. الشهوة, when someone commits something حرام, he knows it's haram. هو الزاني, when he commits زنا, if he thinks it's not حرام, he's كافر. مستحل لك كبيرة, هذا ايش؟ كافر. في فرق بين المستحل وبين المصر. عندنا أهل السنة والجماعة, we differentiate. عندك فرق, إذا if he commits in a once, خلاص هذا مخلد في النار. Forever, in eternity, in hell. But someone who considers something known for all Muslims, the small kid and the sheikh and the 10 years old and the scholar, they all know it. Zina haram. يسموه معلوم من الدين بالضرورة. يعني everyone is equal in knowing it. Are there exceptions for it? في استثناء, في استثناء. But in general, everyone knows it. And then someone comes and say, you know what? Zina is not haram. Just like we hear today. They don't say, والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he prepared us for people like that. As in Bukhari. That people will come from this ummah يستحلون حرا. حرا هو الزنا. ما قال يزنون. He said يستحلون. يعني consider الزنا. Okay. والحرير والخمر والمعازف. But the point is, today one of the things that we've been here, we started hearing now frequently, about homosexual. And I'm مؤدب يعني عشان كده بقول لك. Today we have this movement. Movement. And I call it movement of consciousness. That. هذا العمل حلال. ما في في القرآن يثبت إنه حرام. To the point where now they have their own masjids. عندهم مساجد عندهم هذول مساجد. He doesn't feel comfortable in fundamentalist masjid. So he has his own masjid. And if you don't think that is okay, to go read the Rand report, something I talked about before. They categorize Muslims, and then they tell you, if you believe in these things, you're a fundamentalist Muslim. If you believe in these things, you're a fanatic Muslim. If you believe in these things, you're modern. If you feel in these things, if you believe in these things, you're reformist. The point is one. And subhanAllah, the first three, fundamentalist, fanatic, what's the third eye? I don't even remember.
Experience.
One of those names they use.
Conservative.
No Muslim wants to be identified like this. Fundamentalist? No, I'm not fundamentalist. Fanatic? No, I'm not fanatic. Guess what? Got bad news for you. According to this report, you are. Actually, you are the three of them. Ashi? What's the point? Why they issue these reports? These reports are issued for the government, for the states, so they can know, So that's why when you go into the airport, and they start giving you a hard time, because they take you and they fit you in those carriers. He fits here. Or you don't need to go to the airport, Mama, they're watching you. Those three, as I remember, those three, if you believe, the Quran and the Sunnah, the best way to rule the people, you're one of those three. If you still believe in hijab is wajib, you're one of those three people. If you believe salah is obligatory, you're one of the three. That's how simple it has become. So the only Muslim that they will be satisfied with, as Allah Azza wa Jal says, Subhanallah. Allah, Allah, Sadiq. The problem we have, the book of Allah is clear. وَلَن تَرْضَى عِنْكَ الْيَهُودَ وَالْنَصَرَ حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَهُمْ. هم, you think they want you to become Christian or Jew? هم, they don't care. They don't care. They have no religion. هم, they don't care. Actually, you can never become a Jew. Unless your mother is a Jew. And no, don't go and tell her to convert so you become a Jew. لا. It's a blood. It's a cult. Humma, they are not concerned about you becoming Christian or Jew. Humma, their own main concern is one thing, to become Catholic. Buddhist, Hindu, satanic, whatever, Satan worshiper, it doesn't matter. But don't be Muslim. But if you're going to insist to continue to be Muslim, then we're going to tell you exactly what kind of Islam you need to live. الله عز وجل ودوا لو تكفروا ما كفروا فتكونون سواء. Now you can come and tell me والله and I have Christians good friends and they're supportive. يا أخي الاستثناءات and the exceptions cannot be applied to the general masses. Well, you're going to have exceptions everywhere. When we say Allah Azza wa Jal encompasses everything, why you say that? We know that. Allah muhit bi kul shay. Why you say that? We say because they were groups who say and who claim to be on the straight path, they deviate. For example, عندك groups like لو العقلانيين we hear them today. هو just the names change with time. But هم هم. In the past called معتزلي أو المعتزلة. Today they call themselves عقلانيين. وليبرالي وعلماني كله إن البقرة تشابه عليه. بطلنا نفرق. We cannot differentiate anymore. صفراء عمراء كله the cows are looking all alike just like the juice. بس هي اسماء ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان. ماشي؟ خلاص هو بيقول لك بنحط العقل before السمع. السمع يعني الوحي. حط العقل. أنا if it makes sense to me I accept. If it doesn't make sense to my brain I reject. So came and they said, Allah has no names or attributes. Allah is not Alim. Allah is not Kareem. Allah is not Rahim. Allah is not, Allah is not. Allah doesn't have this. Allah cannot see. Allah cannot hear. Why you say all that? Well, what he wants to do? He wants to elevate Allah over the creation. He wants to ascend Allah. In his mind, and how can I say Allah knows? And I know too. So now I'm comparing Allah to me. Allah doesn't know. Instead of saying, I don't know, he says, Allah doesn't know. Because he cannot deny he doesn't know. But those same people, if you come to him and ask him, Allah hay, he tells you yes. Well, because if he's not hay, then. طيب, if you, طب معنى حي كما, معنى أحياء. Why you confirm الحياة for Allah, even though we are أحياء as well. طيب, why you cannot approve or you cannot admit that Allah hears and we hear as well. ماشي؟ هذا تخبط. Those who deviate always contradict themselves. So طيب, all these names and attributes in the Quran, they said مجاز. It's all symbolic and figurative. Allah say it, but so we can understand. But He doesn't mean it. He means something else that we cannot understand. We can understand what hearing means. So He wants just for us. يعني Allah is sending something at, so we can understand. Because if He tells us what He is really, there's no way we can understand. Yes, there is things we cannot understand, and that is الكيفية. That is how we cannot understand. That's why He didn't tell us. Allah didn't tell us how He hears. Allah didn't tell us how He sees everything. Allah didn't tell us how He knows the thought. Didn't tell us. Because it's something we don't need and something we cannot understand. But He told us He knows. That's good enough. So going deeper and starting to look for those philosophies and philosophical نهل الكلام tried هذا تقعر سمو تقعر and then another group came and they said لا 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 الله عليم الله سميع الله عليم but بدون علم الله knows but without knowledge. Even if you come to the simplest person and tell him that, say you're crazy. Allah hears, but without hearing, I could look at him. Allah Azza wa Jal أنزله بعلمه, as He says in the Quran. أنزله, the book, بعلمه. So He سبحانه وتعالى, Allah says, ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه. فهو He سبحانه وتعالى tells you, my علم. His knowledge. Who are you to come and deny it? فأهل السنة والجماعة وسط. Makes things very simple. Makes things very simple. Allah says بعلمه بعلمه. Allah says He has knowledge. We say He has knowledge. Obviously, because we said yet last time ليس كمثله شيء. Based on that, nothing is like Him. Based on that, He has ilm, it's different than our ilm. He hears, it's different than how he hears. He sees, it's different than... And end of the story. There isn't... now complicated things, man. It's not part of this deen. This deen is for everyone. Now, had a deen sent to الأميين. هو الذي بعث في الأميين. أمي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أمي. Cannot write or read. You're gonna come tell them سميع بدون سمع وعليم بدون علم. والله is not inside the world and it's not outside the world and it's not on the right of the world and it's not for what? For what? Allah says الرحمن على العرش استوى. شو محلها؟ شو مجملها؟ شوف it shakes hearts. الرحمن على العرش استوى. And they go read surah والرحمن على العرش استوى. It says and just think of your heart. My imagine Ar-Rahman not outside the world, not inside the world. Imagine هذا هبل. هذا this is what these عقلانيين calling for. They put their brains that the person makes a million decisions in his life and he regrets and then he wants to know Allah with his brain. أنت يو You still cannot, cannot make the right decision for yourself about what you're gonna eat next. You wanna know Allah with your intellect. فعلم الله تعالى أزلي. إيش أزلي؟ علم الله تعالى أزل. Eternal. Means what? Means that it was never preceded, by ignorance. Simple. يعني it's not حادث. It's not something new. أنت you come from the womb of your mother, know nothing. You don't know anything. And then you learn. ماشي. هذا your علم. I'm teaching you this and reminding myself of this. I wasn't born knowing this. I learned it. The way you're learning now, I learned it at one point. So before I knew it, I was ignorant of it. The ilm of Allah is not like that. The ilm of Allah is eternal. Was never preceded by ignorance. Clear? هذا when we say علم الله أزلي. Because it's nuts to say that Allah was ignorant and then became knowledge. A God cannot be like that. Like Buddha. Buddha was from rich family. And he went one day and he started reflecting. And he got enlightened. He was ignorant. That's why he got enlightened. That's what they say. I even think Buddhism, that's what it means. The enlightenment. He figured it out. Which is a proof that he's not God. And they say that it's a proof he's not God. Because your God was ignorant and at one point. فالله عز وجل ما زال بكل شيء عليما. الأزل يعني ما زال. He's been, has been, and continue to be. When you say he has been, grammatically means he was in the past and he's in the present and continue to be. Actually, that's he has been. Do you come, now you sing the masjid, I ask you. You say, well, I drove here. But when you leave, and stay here too long, I call you up. What's happening? Well, I've been driving for the last 30 minutes. I've been driving. You start in the past, you are doing it, and you continue. Allah Azza wa Jal, الأزل ما زال. He had knowledge in the past. He still has knowledge, continue to have. How far? There is no. That's where eternity comes. أزل, eternity. But someone can bring شبهة and say, طيب. Why Allah Azza wa Jal in the Quran says, that he does certain things or he allows or يشاء certain things to know. Like what? Like Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا الْقِبْلَةَ الَّتِي كُنْتَ عَلَيْهَا إِلَّا لِنَعْلَمَ مَنْ يَتَّبِعَ الرَّسُولِ مَنْ يَتَّبِعَ الرَّسُولِ. So Allah says that. You come to the literal translation of this, it says, you know the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was staring at the sky because he wanted his heart for the Qibla to be Mecca. And you know, for 16 months they were praying toward Bayt al-Maqdis. Jerusalem, Masjid al-Aqsa. And that was also the Qibla of the Jews. Quds. So Allah Azza wa Jal, or the Prophet ﷺ, wanted in his heart to pray toward قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ قِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا. Allah Azza wa Jal says, when the Jews said, what kind of God is this? One day he tells them pray toward Al-Aqsa, and one day he tells them pray toward Mecca. فالله عز وجل وما جعلنا القبلة التي كنت عليها إلا لنعلم من يتبع الرسول ينقلب. It's a test. We made the change in the Qibla so we will know who will be firm with these rumors and this shubha, who will continue to be firm and turn along with you from those who gonna turn away from you. Allah says, لِنَعْلَمْ, so we will know. But the question becomes, يعني Allah didn't know? يعني Allah, before He changed the Qibla, didn't know who will stay with the Prophet ﷺ and who will turn away? Now we said He knows everything will be, what will be, everything that will happen. We said He knows what does not happen, had it happen, what it will be or what it will look like. So obviously that's not the meaning that intended. Actually, it's not for sure, because علم الله أزلي. Okay, eternal back and eternal forward. يعني there is no point where Allah becomes تعالى الله ignorant, or at one point he stopped knowing what will happen. So obviously, the meaning of this ayah and similar ayat in the Quran is not what we see. Allah, for example, says, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَعْلَمِ اللَّهِ. The other ayah, حَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُ وَيَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَلَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّا الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهِ. So Allah tests people and He says, so we would know who's the believer and who's the hypocrite. But Allah, He needs to test them to know. He doesn't need this. So what is this علم? علم الموجود. هذا العلماء يسموه علم الظهور. إيش علم الظهور؟ يعني the علم of appearance. إيش يعني الله عز وجل will not punish someone because he knew that this person, if the Qibla would have changed, he would turn away from him. Out of justice. Allah, let's assume Allah does not change the Qibla. On the Day of Judgment, He will not punish someone that had He changed the Qibla, this person would have turned away from the Prophet. He will not do that because it's not just. So He will have to, or He will, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He doesn't have to do anything, He will, subhanahu wa ta'ala, make it exist. So this person has no argument against Allah. فهذا العلم علم الظهور. It didn't happen, but Allah knows it will happen. But it didn't happen. It didn't happen. So Allah will make it happen for the results that we mentioned. So the علم of the موجود أو علم الظهور حتى تقام الحجة على العبد. So there is no argument. يعني Allah will not come to a Muslim on the day of judgment and say you're going to hellfire. Why? Because if you lived until the Dajjal, you would have followed him. But this person died before the Dajjal, for example. Allah doesn't do that. Why? Because this person can argue. I believe that you know everything. And you know what will be of me. But the human nature does not believe until it sees. So to establish the hujjah and the argument on the person, Allah will make it happen. And that's the meaning of this ayah. So Allah doesn't need to test someone to know if he's patient or he's not. He knows how he's going to react. Allah knows how this person is going to react when his father dies, when his mother dies. But when someone says, والله أنا if my father dies, I'm gonna be saying حسبي إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون from the moment I hear it. And then his father dies, and he starts weeping and wailing and crying and cursing and why my father and this, and he was a nice guy and he was a nice dude. Death about who's nice and who's not. كل ميت يا حبيبي. So this is also a benefit for the believers. And I, والله, I thought I had too much patience. I thought I trusted Allah. So Allah puts you through a test to show you, to show you your true metal. And this is how men are made. This is how real men, not like males, men are made. Because Islam differentiates between men and males. من المؤمنين رجال. يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى. فرق بين الذكر شيخ فرق بين الذكر والرجل. امرأة قد تكون رجل صح ولا يعني من هذا المنطلق. From this perspective that we take رجل means والرجل إيش يعني مترجل. He's ready, standing, ready.
يعني الله مترجل.
لا إحنا إذا بنأخذها من هذه المنطلق نتكلم بمسائل الصبر والتضحية والإيمان والقوة. لما الله يقول من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عهد الله. Is this رجال only men؟ ألا يتعني فقط يعني صحابة ذكور ولا يقع فيها بعض النساء اللي جاهدوا؟ So the Islam differentiates, but just the fact that someone has testosterone doesn't make him رجل. والله لو لبس إيش لو لبس تاج فرعون يجي يقول أنا الرجل أخذ له كم من إبرة تستيرويد أخذ له كم من إبرة عشان يعمل عضلات يقول لك رجل وهذا تعمل له كذا عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه last crown climbs a tree the Sahaba see his legs very scrawny legs so they start laughing So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, تضحكون من دقة ساقي. You're laughing from the scrawniness of his legs. They weigh in the sight of Allah more than the mountains of Uhud. وابو جهل. الله عز وجل. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, يكاد الرجل السمين يوم القيامة. Fat on the day of judgment. Put in the ميزان. ما له وزن هباء منه هاشم قدمنا إلى ما عملوا من عمل جهنم أبدا قل لن ننبئكم بالأخسرين أعمالا الذين ضل سعيهم في الحياة الدنيا وهم يحسبون أنهم يحسنون صنعا لهم أعمال كجبال تهام أو تهام mountains they come with good deeds as big as the mountains يجعلها الله هباء منثورا ما هي بالوزن ما هي بالذكورة it's all about actions it's all about the actions ماشي وهذا الله عز وجل يحاسبك على هذا أما الله عز وجل ليعلم الذين آمنوا يعلم المنافقين يعلم الصالحين والكاذبين So you know where you stand. You know where you stand. Everyone can make claims. Prophet Hassan says, لا تتمنوا لقاء العدو. Fair. But this is as tiskia to the nafs. Until you say, and I'm so brave. I want to open the door. لا. ولا تزكوا أنفسكم. We're not allowed to praise ourselves. هو أعلم بمن اتقى. He knows how you will react. So at one point, he can expose you to you. شوف رمضان comes every year. رمضان هذا يعني exposes everyone to himself. تقول مسجد بعيد. المسجد this. أنا I feel lazy to go to the masjid. أنا ما عندي. في رمضان suddenly you're every night in the masjid. And not only that, قيام too. وتهجد. وفجر. خلاص رمضان exposes you. It's telling you That means you can. That means you can. Means you can quit smoking. Because you're not smoking during the day. Yes, but you're playing in your head. Or your head playing in your head. You stop the whole from Fajr to Maghrib. That means Allah Azza wa Jal will not order someone or tell someone something haram and not, giving him the ability to stay away from it. Because that will be dhulm, oppression. Just like when people tamper with their religion, that's what happens. Sure, the Christians, they come up with this thing, the Catholics, they come up with this thing, celibacy. Sure, what's happening in the church. Mustahil, impossible, Allah to order people to do something that he did not give them the mechanism or the ability to resist. So when they came up, know that this celibacy is something made up. There is no way every man has a desire that he needs to fulfill. To come and tell him, you're going to be priest and you're going to be the servant of God, don't get married. So he doesn't get married. And then what? The Pope has to resign. That's why he resigned. Because of all these scandals. خلاص هو he cannot be with them. Who he gonna take every, the shaitan will beautify every opportunity for him. Well, they're putting him with 30 children. That's the reality. ماشي? Islam is the religion of nature. Islam is a religion that exactly understands human. In every aspect. We have to believe in that. We have to present that. We have to convey that. In every aspect. When the Muslim scholar came, they invited him to debate with their priests. So he walked in. He said, Hello. مرحبا. قال كيف أولادكم؟ هاجوا وثابوا. So how you talk to them like that? These are priests. They don't have children. How you ask them how their children? He said, Subhanallah. You get offended because I say you have children. Yet in the same hand you say Allah has children. And say Allah has a son. He said, I'm leaving. فبهت الذي كفر خلاص انتهى الموضوع. Into how you put yourself, As the joke that this guy went to the Vatican. He wants to become a priest. So the Pope told him, okay, the first task, I want to go downstairs, and to copy the Bible, the original Bible. So he goes, and 2 weeks, 2 months pass, and the guy's not out. So he goes, the Pope goes, and he finds him crying. So what happened? He said, it's not celibate, it's celebrate. You guys got it? And it's not celibacy. There's no such thing, it's celebrate. But they changed it. Huh? The point is, Ummah, they tampered with it. هو موسى هم يعني if it's in if they understand هو موسى didn't get married إبراهيم didn't عليه السلام the prophet يوسف نوح why suddenly Allah will tell the next prophet to be a religious you don't get married why ثم لهم قلوب لا يفقهون بها هذول مغشي غشاوة ختم الله على قلوبهم طيب إذن when Allah says ليعلم هو he wants to establish the argument for you or against you So if he comes in the day of judgment, he say, he will not judge you saying, had I tested you with this, you would have gone this way. Allah will not do that. Out of his justice, he will not do that. That's why Allah sent the prophets and the messengers. For what? To establish the argument. حتى لا يكون لله على الناس أو حتى يكون الناس على الله حجة بعد الرسل. ما سنت messenger after messenger after messenger. Prophet after prophet, book after book. So people will not come to them and say, well, you didn't send us anyone. Actually. So we stop here, inshallah, and we continue next time. أقول قولي هذا. أستغفر الله لي ولكم. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد. الحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.